Collection. Hi, we're a collection and we're from sunny Dorset.
My name's Brynley, I'm 64.
Stop.
Hi, I'm Brynley, I'm 64, retired from Ferndown in Dorset.
Hello, I'm Chris, I'm retired, I'm 71. I'm from Dorset. Hi, I'm Chris, I'm 71, I'm retired and I'm from Wimborne in Dorset.
Hi, I'm Eric, I'm 69, I'm also retired and I'm from Corfmullen in Dorset.
Hi, I'm Brynley, I'm the team leader and chose the team name in collection based on when I went to free concerts in Hyde Park and Parliament Fields in London, where there's a group called In Collection, and I thought it was a good word and I put it in the back of my mind and brought it out for this opportunity. We're made up mostly of artists who are eclectic in their different qualities which come together, but to be truly eclectic we need a contrast within the team. Now, my main interest, subject-wise, is history, and we're sitting on a tumulus here in Dorset, and it's a very interesting historic and has relevance in literature, because Thomas Hardy used to cycle the same paths that we've just been cycling. And indeed, he did write Far From the Madding Crowd, and we certainly are. And in Far From the Madding Crowd, there is a chapter, A Tryst on an Ancient Earthworks. So we're sort of living the novel to in a way. Now, I've found two things interesting here on our cycling from time to time. One is this sea urchin, fossil sea urchin, and something which I thought was a fantastic find was what I believe to be a pterosaur claw. But having sent a photograph to it to the Natural History Museum, they tell me that it's a cow's toba. So that's a bit of a disappointment. But it's a wonderful area. This we have, well, Wimborne Minster that way, Blandford Forum in that direction, which I used to be a textile designer, indeed I was head of fashion textiles, and a community arts officer, which is where I've located the artists for the group. And Blandford Forum, for example, has what I regard as the best museum for fashion and textiles, because you can don those white gloves and you can examine 18th century costumes for the interesting facts they have, like what the museum wanted to sell, and indeed the fabulous construction